Hello and thank you for choosing Translation Exchange as your localization partner. In this video, we will show you how to integrate Squarespace website with Translation Exchange and get your website localized in any language. I have a basic Squarespace website that I just created. In order to proceed with integration, we need to have a project created on Translation Exchange platform. Let's quickly go through those steps. Let's create a website integration. Choose a Squarespace icon. Let's add project details. We'll name our project Squarespace Test 1. We'll leave source language as English. You can always change source language to any other language that you prefer. Let's choose Spanish as our target language. Web URL is where you place actual URL of your website, if you already know. If you don't, this steps is optional, but for now I will leave it empty and I can always edit later. So let's create a project. This steps I will follow exactly in the video to complete the integration. Let's follow this and integrate the code into our Squarespace. That's the code that has the key that was created for that specific project. I will just copy this to my desktop. Let's go back to our site. So we'll go to Settings, Advanced, Code Injection, and we need to paste that code, and that's pretty much it. Click Save. And that pretty much completes our integration. But it would be always nice to show users that our website is available in other languages. So we need to add language selector. So I will show you three simple steps just to get started. The first one is very simple. You can just back into Code Injection. You can just add language selector section, language selector to true, and click Save. That will automatically edit language selector on the side. If you want to be a little more advanced or different, you can add a simple div section in a Squarespace navigation and either primary or secondary navigation, or if you actually have access to the code, if you're in advanced development center of the Squarespace, you can add the same div section anywhere on any page to show our pre-built language selector. So I'll leave that one on so you can see a few options. Go back to advanced. I'll go back to Pages, click on Page, and let's add Main Navigation. So we'll do a link, and we'll just copy that link here from our page, put in the title, and we'll add pretty much anywhere, click Save. Right here, that's added our navigation language selector on a main navigation page. You can add it in the secondary navigation page, or anywhere else. And again, if you have actual access to the code, you can add that simple HTML div tag anywhere on a page. So last step is to verify that it worked. You can just click verify right here, or you can skip the verification. For now, I'll just skip the verification. If you already have some files that you have from different translation services, you can drop them here with your strings. If you don't, we'll just go back to dashboard. That's pretty much it. That's our dashboard, but there are no strings, no sources. We're not done yet. So in order to get strings extracted from our website, we need to go into translation mode. So that's our page. Let me just refresh that this is actual page already. So you see all the language selected we placed. Well, let's just go activate translation mode. Once we do that, we have the Spanish already. As you can see, all the strings that are underlined in red, they've been already extracted into our dashboard. And if I refresh our dashboard, we'll see all our strings in here. That now completes integration of Squarespace and Translation Exchange. Thank you for watching.